Don't wanna get ahead of myself, feeling things I've never felt. It's kind of hard for me to explain her personality and everything. Brings me to my knees.
Getting a little bit naughty, get it?
Because
I tied it in the knot.
I wanna take it slow, but it's so hard. I love to see her face in daylight. It's more than just our bodies at night. But she's really tempting me. Oh, do you think I'm being foolish if I don't rush in? She might be it, that the love is real, that the shoe might fit. She might just be my everything. Beyond space and time in the afterlife. Will she have my kids? Will she be my wife? She might just be my everything. Beyond, I wanna bring her round to meet you. Thinking like a candelina. I know that grandma would have loved her like she was her own. She makes me feel
gorgeous.
I can't be up here.
Oh, yeah, Kyle's gonna cry.
Might be it, that the love is real, that the shoe might fit. She might just be my everything. Beyond space and time in the afterlife. Will she have my kids? Will she be my wife? She might just be my everything. Beyond, I give up, I'm in love, trying.
Because I love Uncle Mario. Okay,
I'm
going a little bit higher.
Okay. So do you think I'm being foolish if I don't rush in? I'm scared to death that she might be it, that the love is real, that the shoe might
fit.
He's
such a good writer.
She might just be my everything.
Hi. Oh, yeah.
Oh,
hello.
You look amazing.
What?
Sorry.
Okay. You had fun today?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I want to see you. You're good.
You look amazing. Oh.
I was
trying
not to cry.
You're shaking.
I got makeup on. I've been shaking all day long.
I'm about to see you. You ready? Mm-hmm. Me too.
I liked your letter.
You like that?
Mm-hmm.
This is good.
Oh, did you write a whole book?
No. I didn't know how much I was supposed to write. Oh, that's not awesome. I have a tissue in my pocket, but...
Oh.
That's all you get.
All the tears I get?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Ready? And you're walking inside sideways. The wine always affects you in beautiful kind ways. Ask me if I'm staying, and I say that I'm sleeping on the floor. Won't you tell me that you need me? Cause lately I've been needing someone to remind me worth more than just an evening. I woke to kitchen smoke, you dancing like God's moved in you before. Well, you
greatest sense of joy. Thank you for letting us have a great day together, volunteers, friends, and family. We love you so much, Lord. We're grateful for you. In your name we pray.
Amen.
I don't wanna hide. I've been waiting for you all damn night. Sundress, all undressed with nails on your skin turning white. Getting high out in Austin, drunk in Tennessee. I don't care where I am, as long as you're with me. Those boys downtown talk so much shit when I leave. Well, look at I'll do, look at I'll do, oh, look at I'll do. 'Cause in you, I'm new, I'm new, oh, how I'm new. The way the grass smells at night, and you got flames all in your eyes, as they reflect the sparkler, and you say we'll never die. Grab me by the hands, just as calloused as I am, and say you're proud.
Wise men say only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you.
Dearly beloved, we have come together in the presence of God to witness and bless the joining together of this man and this woman in holy matrimony. The bond and covenant of marriage was established by God in creation, and our Lord Jesus Christ adorned this manner of life by his presence and first miracle at the wedding of Cana of Galilee. It signifies to us the mystery of the union between Christ and his church, and Holy Scripture commends it to be honored among all people. The union of husband and wife in heart, body, and mind is intended by God for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given one another in prosperity and adversity, and when it is God's will, for the procreation of children and their nurture in the knowledge and love of the Lord. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God. Into this holy union, Kyle and Tara now come to be joined. Who presents this bride?
Her mother and I. Here, my man. Take care of him.
Tara, will you have this man to be your husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Kyle, will you have this woman to be your wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, Honor and keep her, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live.
I will.
Friends, join with us today. This question is addressed to you. Will you, all witnessing these promises, do all in your power to uphold these two persons in their marriage?
We will.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O gracious and ever-living God, you have created us male and female in your image. Look mercifully upon this man and this woman who come to you seeking your blessing, and assist them with your grace, that with true fidelity and steadfast love they may honor and keep the promises and vows they make through Jesus Christ our Savior, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. Prepare now your hearts for the reading of God's Word.
Psalm 67. May God be merciful to us and bless us. Show us the light of his countenance and come to us. Let your ways be known upon earth, your saving health among all nations. Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you. Let the nations be glad and sing for joy, for you judge the peoples with equity and guide all the nations upon earth. Let the peoples praise you, O God, let all the peoples praise you. The earth has brought forth her increase. May God, our own God, give us his blessing. May God give us his blessing, and may all the ends of the earth stand in awe of him.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Put on then, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, compassionate hearts, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bearing with one another, and if one has a complaint against another, forgiving each other, as the Lord has forgiven you, so you must also forgive. And above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you are called in one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, teaching and admonishing one another in all wisdom, singing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs with thankfulness in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord.
And thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Father, thank you for the ways you have united Tara and Kyle to yourself. We pray, Father, that you would knit them to one another, knit them also to your Son. In his name we pray. Amen. All right. This is the time for the homily, so you're gonna have to face me. I'm gonna be talking to everyone, but mostly to y'all. And it is to you on this most special day. You look beautiful, Tara. Kyle, gentlemen, your ankles are showing, which is a choice. It was a choice I respect deeply. This is a profoundly beautiful day. It's something you have been longing for and planning for so long. And everything has gone so well so far. But the homily is not about today, as beautiful as it is, and it's not about other beautiful times you'll have. We're about to celebrate the holidays together as a couple. There's gonna be so many great days ahead of you, but I wanna talk real briefly about bad days that are ahead of you too, and what you'll need. Because on days like this, we all kind of know what we need. You know, it's easy to go outside. It's cool enough that socks are optional. Everything just feels kind of nice, and you know, you can sort of muster through. But there will be days, as we'll say in our vows in a moment, of sickness and of want. And on those days, I just want to say very briefly three things that you will need and that you are supplied with today. You have promises of three things. And the first thing you have a promise of is our Lord Jesus Christ and his Holy Spirit. You will need to turn to God. And God will be incumbent upon you at moments when you as a family feel hopeless, despondent, to turn the gaze of your family upward, to look to the Lord. You will need prayer, and you will need Christ. In a moment, I'm going to wrap. This is called a stole that's around my neck, and it's supposed to represent a yoke. And in the Gospels, Jesus says that his yoke is easy and light, and a yoke is just something you harness to an animal, and it's something that signified lordship. And preachers wear yokes because it's meant to convey that when they speak, they're speaking as for Christ, that we can't bind consciences beyond what Christ has said, that we are under the lordship of Jesus. In a moment, I'm going to wrap this yoke around your hands. I'm going to take it off and wrap it in your hands, and signifying that in your darkest days, Jesus has you, he is holding you, and you can look to him. Second, I just ask a question to the congregation, and I ask them if they would vow to support you. Now, today, you really don't need a ton of support. This is a beautiful day. At Christmas, you're not going to need a ton of support. It'll be a beautiful day. Thanksgiving. But there will be a time in your life where you will need others. And the great temptation of all of us, but I think specifically of us Dallas people who like to present things like we always have it together and we're never, there's no problems. You need to humbly reach out and ask for help. And everybody in this room, certainly everybody in your church family, everybody would love and has been there themselves where they need help. They need assistance. And you have that. You have the family of Christ, and you have people in this room who love you deeply. It'll be incumbent upon you on dark days to turn to them, because they, just as the Spirit is present with you and vows to uphold you and keep you as you abide in Christ, so too does everybody in this room solemnly vow to support you and your new marriage. So you need the Spirit, you need the congregation, and lastly, you need one another. You'll make vows momentarily. This homily is rapidly coming to conclusion. This is not going to be 40 minutes. There's delicious appetizers over there, I saw. You have one another. You are making vows that you will not only be supportive of the other, but be supported by the other. You will turn and look in the eyes of the other, and in the eyes of the other, you will find your help, your consolation. And you'll not only smile together, but you'll cry together, and you will uphold one another. And as you do that, you will have the Spirit of God, and you'll have the people of God. And on the darkest days, the promises made to you now will be fulfilled insofar as you trust one another, the Spirit of Christ, and the Church of Christ. And so now we turn to the making of vows. Are you ready? All right. Well, Kyle, I'm going to ask you to take Tara's left hand, and you're going to repeat after me. In the name of God, I, Kyle, take you, Tara.
In the name of God, I, Kyle, take you, Tara.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Tara, if you'll take Kyle's left hand and repeat after me. In the name of God, I, Tara, take you, Kyle.
In the name of God, I, Tara, take you, Kyle.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Are there rings? Bless, O Lord, these rings to be a sign of the vow by which this man and this woman have bound themselves to each other through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Kyle, take Tara's ring, placing it on her left ring finger. Repeat after me. Tara, I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow.
Tara, I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Tara? Taking Kyle's ring and placing it on his left hand, repeat after me. Kyle, I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow.
Kyle, I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Now that Kyle and Tara have given themselves to each other by such solemn vows, with the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of a ring, I pronounce that they are husband and wife, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Amen. Let us pray. Eternal God, creator and preserver of all life, author of salvation and giver of all grace, look with favor upon the world that you have made and for which your Son gave his life, and especially upon this man and this woman whom you make one flesh in holy matrimony. Amen. Give them wisdom and devotion in the ordering of their common life, that each may be to the other a strength in need, a counselor in perplexity, a comfort in sorrow, and a companion in joy. Amen. Grant that their wills may be so knit together in your will and their spirits in your spirit, that they may grow in love and peace with you and with one another all the days of their life. Amen. Give them grace when they hurt each other, to recognize and acknowledge their fault, and to seek each other's forgiveness and yours. Amen. Make their lives together a sign of Christ's love to this sinful and broken world, that unity may overcome estrangement, forgiveness heal guilt, and joy conquer despair. Amen. Bestow upon them, if it is your will, the gift and heritage of children, and the grace to bring them up to know you, to love you, and to serve you. Amen. Give them such fulfillment for their mutual affection that they may reach out in love and concern for others. Amen. Grant that all married persons who have now witnessed these vows may find their lives strengthened and their loyalties confirmed. Amen. Grant that the bonds of our common humanity, by which all our children are united one to another and the living to the dead, may be so transformed by your grace that your will may be done on earth as it is in heaven, where, O Father, with your Son and the Holy Spirit, you live and reign in perfect unity, now and forever. Amen. Most gracious God, we give you thanks for your tender love in sending Jesus Christ to come among us, to be born of a human mother, and to make your way to the cross to be the way of life. We thank you also for consecrating the union of man and woman in his name. By the power of your Holy Spirit, pour out the abundance of your blessing upon this man and this woman. Defend them from every enemy. Lead them into all peace. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts, a mantle about their shoulders, and a crown upon their foreheads. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, in their sleeping and in their waking, in their joys and in their sorrow, in their life and in their death. Finally, in your mercy, bring them to that table where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully, with his favor, look upon you and fill you with all spiritual benediction and grace, that you may faithfully live together in this life and in the age to come. Amen. Brothers and sisters, if you will see the final page of your bulletin, we will pray this prayer for mission together. O God, the giver of all that is true and lovely and gracious, we give you thanks for binding us together in these holy mysteries of the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that by your Holy Spirit, Kyle and Tara, now joined in holy matrimony, may become one in heart and soul, live in fidelity and peace, and obtain those eternal joys prepared for all who love you, for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I bless you in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. Ladies and gentlemen, I now pronounce to you Mr. and Mrs. Kyle Sobey. Kyle, you may kiss the bride.
Good, still spinning the scene of the crime. It's looking like a tornado might have come crashing through the dome. You can't see what happened, but one thing's for sure. The moon shot on through a thin piece of glass, and the stars must have blushed when you kissed me. All the last I recall was a quarter till two. We headed back to my place like two strangers do.
Alright, well, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, if y'all will be seated, I promise you it was not their first dance song, but if anyone would please be seated at this time, as you too get to share your first dance as husband and wife.
Been involved with wedding, you know, it takes about 6 months. You're supposed to propose, get married in 6 months. You can't get married in 30 days because you got to have 6 months for the bride and the mother of the bride to plan the wedding.
That's 4 months.
Okay. Well, during that period, the father of the bride and the groom, all they listen to is wedding talk. Incessantly, the colors, the flowers, the food, the venue, the ceremony, it goes on and on and on. You almost get a little tired of it, okay? But it takes a lot of work. I want to thank Cal's parents for their help putting this together. Thank you so much. It appears we're going to have a fantastic band. You can thank Cal for that. Thank you, Kyle. He stepped up. And mostly, we need to thank my wife, Cynthia. Cynthia. So, tonight, Kyle, you have gained a wife. Hopefully, after 6 months to a year, I'll regain mine. Okay? When Tara talked to me about Kyle, oh, he's nice, he's handsome, he's kind and considerate, he's smart, he's a hard worker, he's got a job. she just really laid it on to me. And then she said, and Dad, best for you, he's not a Yankee. So I was glad to hear that. So when Kyle decided that he wanted to marry Tara, he invited me to Hudson House to talk about it. Hudson, if none of you have been to Hudson House, we went to the one in Las Colinas, it's fantastic. And Kyle, I'll tell you, it is a conversation I will never forget. It was emotional, it was very touching. I felt blessed knowing that I was going to have such another outstanding son. And I love you. Thank you. Things happen in your life. Life can be, marriage can be black and white. You know, you can be favored by prosperity and blasted by adversity. My life has been that. My wife and I have three great children. They've been a wonderful blessing to our life. And then we've also had a cancer doctor tell me your wife has a 27% chance of living 5 years. That strikes you. Guess what? He was wrong. And I can tell you that through the years, through our ups and downs with my wife's health, we work together in business and the stresses and, you know, that come with operating a small business. You know, we've had our downs, we've had our ups. But I'll tell you this, I have never been unhappy in spite of that. And Cynthia and I pray that in 42 years, you can say the same thing. God bless you. We love you. So, I don't have a glass, but if Will Ray's, y'all have a wonderful marriage, a wonderful wedding. It is a wonderful wedding. Have a wonderful wedding. Thanks so much. Very good. I love you.
Stomach. I will wait for you till the sun turns into ashes and bows down to the moon. I will wait for you. It's a long, hard war, oh, but I can grin and bear it, 'cause I know what the hell I'm fighting for, and I will wait for you. We were never made to run forever. We were just meant to go long enough to find what we were chasing after. I believe I found it here in your love. I will stand my ground. I'm a bad man looking for takers. Finest thing around, so I will stand my ground. 'Cause it's cold out there, and you know some men search for ages for the love that I have found, so I will stand my ground. We were never made to run forever. We were just meant to go long enough. Find what we were chasing after. I believe I found it here in your love. Honey, I will wait for you. Honey, I will stand my ground. I will work for you till my hands are tired and bleeding. I know what it is from us I'm needing. I will work for you. Like a team of mules pulling hell off from its hinges. It's a love that I'll keep tending. I will work for you. Forever, we were just meant to go long enough to find what we were chasing after. I believe I found it here in your love. Honey, I will wait for you. Honey, I will stand my ground.
One more kiss, one more kiss!
Yeah, I want one of these.
You'll test this, won't you?
Yeah, but what are these?